thought I'd show you what I'm doing now. I'm making a better lid, or a plug. I've changed the name from lid to plug, because it sits inside. This with the plaster cast sits inside the mould really snug and tight like a plug. The first one was not very good, and the mask is quite thick, so I had to cut some areas away. You can see. I'm making this, I'm going to finish this for MrOpenWeatherPeople.net, and I'll make another one for the competition. It's the plastic cast. What I did here was take the rubber out, sit it on on a small bowl to keep its shape, and I slowly filled it with clay. I took the clay cast out, then I carved down the features. So it really made it simple, made the eyes bigger and carved away the mouth detail. And I did that until it sit snugly in there, like it sit touching the inside. And then I took it out. And I put a rubbish bag in there, sit it in there, put the plastic, the clay cast in there. And then melted some clay, waited till it had kind of cooled down a bit, until it was touchable, then pressed it around the edge of the clay cast. Then I built a wall, then I filled that with a melted more clay and filled it up. Then I took that clay cast out and I put it here, and I'm gonna get some alginate from mold. I have two bags, I'm gonna get more alginate. I'm going to cover that, then I'm going to get some plaster bandage and cover that, then I'm going to take that plaster bandage off, take the alginate off, put the alginate back into the plaster bandage, now it's when it's hardened, and fill it up with plaster, the Cristacal plaster. Then I'll mix up some rubber, put that rubber foam, I mean, put that into there. Sit the plaster cast in there on a few small pieces of plastic, very thin. G-clamp it. And G-clamps are... I don't have one viewable. Ah. This is the G-clamp. It's going to hold the plaster cast onto the plastic rubber mould. And then the foam will seep out the holes. And then I'll remove it. So this is, before I didn't carve the features down enough on the plaster cast, that's why the mask was thick, but this one sits really right in there nicely, so there'll be only a thin gap between the finished plaster cast and the mold, and the foam will expand around the plaster cast. And I was thinking, if I won that money for the Barclays competition, I would have money to make a few of these. And I was thinking to make like 10, and then pick around 10 random names from my subscribers list, and they'll win the mask, win a mask. But that's only if I win. I can't do it without that, you know, that's just a small little thing for anyone who backed my idea.